We have discussed so far the meaning, the parties, the essentials, then also the duties of Baili. Now, just like Baili has certain duties, Baili also has been given certain rights as per the contract of bailment provisions. So one by one, discussing these, first right that the Baili has is right to compensation for the defective title. Now, we also discussed this point yesterday as well in the Baili's duties. Sometimes it so happens that bailer's title is not true title, is not good title, means he is not the true owner of the goods and his ownership is defective. Now, because his ownership is defective, true owner is somebody else. True owner comes to know that the goods have been delivered to the Baili. Now, to recover his goods back, he may take action against either the bailer who might have stolen those goods from this true owner, or he can also take a legal action against the Baili who is now possessing those goods. Now, because those legal actions will be taken, in that case, Baili may have to give certain compensation to that person. So, in return, later on, the Baili can recover this compensation from the bailer, because it was bailer's fault because of which you have suffered this kind of loss. So, in context of this, we have discussed one case in the last chapter, Indemnity and Guarantee, Adamson versus Jarvis. To clarify more on this topic, let me once again explain that case in which there was a person who was appointed auctioneer to auction sale cattle of somebody. Now, those cattle, they were stolen cattle, but auctioneer was given the possession of the cattle to be sold. So, in this case, the auctioneer sold those cattle, but the true owner of the cattle arrived at the place and he recovered the cattle back, and he also took legal action against the auctioneer. Auctioneer here was Baili, and the bailer was the one who gave him the auction sale. So in this case, whatever legal charges, whatever legal penalty that auctioneer would have suffered, those will have to be recovered by Baili from the bailer. So it is his right. Secondly, as we have discussed already, right to return is there, that you have to return the goods. Now in case when the goods were bailed to you, it was not bailed to you by one single person. It was joint property of two bailers. So in case two joint bailers have this property, in that case, whom to return back? To one single one or to both of them? So now that depends upon the terms of the contract. In case it was mentioned in the terms of the contract that the goods have to be returned to both the joint bailers, then you have to follow the same. But in case there was no instruction as to the return to any single one or jointly both of them, in that case, you can safely return the goods to one single bailer as well. Third right is right to recover the agreed charges. Now, yesterday we have seen in those videos that the bailment can be gratuitous bailment or it can be a non-gratuitous bailment. So once again, non-gratuitous bailment was the bailment with consideration, in which already some charges were fixed upon, like the case of that taxi hiring, car hiring. So in that case, hourly charges were to be given. So in that case, you are having the right, after the accomplishment of the purpose of the bailment, you have a right to recover those agreed charges, like the hourly higher charges of car were there in the second case, which I discussed yesterday. Next right is right to file suit to court to decide the title of the goods bailed. Now, we have just discussed about the defective title of the bailer. Bailer was not the true owner of the goods. Kisi aur ki goods chori kari aur aapko aage handover kar di. So, in that case, now you are in a dilemma. You are in a fix. You should return the goods back to the bailer from whom you have got the goods, or you should return the goods to the true owner. So, this dilemma has been cleared here in this right. This right says that you can simply apply to court and you can request the court to decide who will get the title of the goods. So in that case, you need not worry about this dilemma and you can simply file a suit with the court and request the court to decide about the return. Next right is the right to file a suit against a wrongdoer. Now, so long as the goods are in your custody, they are bailed with you. We just discussed yesterday, you have a right to have a reasonable care of the goods. Now, you wanted to have reasonable care of the good, but there was a wrongdoer, there was a person who came and he tried to make some damage to the goods. Now, because you have a right to safely preserve those goods with you, in case somebody is trying to damage the goods, you have every right to take a suit or a legal action against that wrongdoer also. Next, last right of Bailey is right of lien. Now, this right of lien is right to retain the possession of the goods and to refuse the return of the goods. So yesterday, we have discussed that after the purpose of bailment is accomplished, Bailey should return the goods back. But in case bailer was supposed to pay some charges for the bailment and he refuses to pay the charges, then Bailey can also refuse to return the goods. So this right to refuse to return the goods is said to be right of lien. So lien means right to retain possession unless your agreed charges are not paid by the bailer. So these are the six rights of Bailey. And the last right of lien is also a detailed topic, which we will discuss later on in the upcoming lectures. Moving on with the rights and duties of the bailer now. So in this case, gratuitous bailment was bailment without consideration. So in case the bailment was without consideration, then you can always terminate the contract at any time because you were not charging anything for that bail. Further, a third right is right to file a suit against any wrongdoer. We just discussed the same right in case of Bailey also, because Bailey was the custodian of the goods. He was a caretaker of the goods. So he can take action against wrongdoer. Similarly, the bailer, being the owner of the goods, he also can suit against a wrongdoer if somebody is trying to damage the goods while they were in the custody of bailer. And when you take a legal action against the wrongdoer and a compensation is received, like in case that car was there on, you have gone for that dinner, and on the way somebody hit the car and the car got damaged, and the bailer or the bailee, they took action against that person, police FIR kar diya unhone, or compensation received. So when you have received some compensation, that compensation will be shared between the bailer and the bailee as per their rights. Fourthly, you also have a right to file suit for enforcement of bailee's duties. Now we have discussed so many of bailee's duty yesterday. So in case bailee is not performing any of those duties which we just mentioned, discussed yesterday, if he's not performing any of the duties well, then also the bailer has a right that he can take action against the bailee, or he can enforce the bailee. He can force the bailee that you have to start performing your duties well. So these were the rights of the bailee. And in between, we also have, today also we discuss in Bailey's right that Bailey has a right of lien. And I told you that this topic is also there for 15 marks question as well, detail. Let us go into the detail of Bailey's lien. So first of all, in case this question comes, you have to explain who is the bailer, who is the bailee, what is the contract of bailment. Bailey has certain rights, and one of those rights is the Bailey's lien. Now coming back to Bailey's lien, as I